Welcome, my friend, to the Chef Lance Show. And tonight we're going to do another weeknight winner, and maybe just under 30 minutes. And what have we made today? We have a Greek chicken and potato casserole. We have a Greek salad topped with feta cheese. And we made a luscious tzatziki sauce and served it with warm pita bread wedges. So let's cook this thing. All right, let's get going. And now what I'm going to do is go ahead and start my timer right now. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to throw in this pita bread into my lower oven, which is I've got on 200 degrees, the lowest setting I have. I just want to warm these through. You remember on prep day, we, by the way, that video is going to be posted in the description and in the a link in the video. So I've got my my triangles of pita bread in here. I'm going to throw those right in the warming oven. Those will be warming throughout the process. Now, I'm going to try to do this in 30 minutes or less, and that doesn't count the oven bake time. We're going to use part of that time as part of the 30 minutes, but I'm talking about active time only. So I'm going to come in here and get the chicken. Now, first thing this morning before I left to go to work, I took my dressing and actually put that over and marinated this chicken. So it's been marinating, I don't know, for 8 hours or 9 hours, whatever time it was I left and then came back. So that's going to be good to go. And we're going to use the rest of the dressing in the dish as well. So first things first, I want to coat my pan with some oil, but I don't have any spray. So what I'm going to do, so I'm going to do it like we did old school back before there was cooking spray. Put a little oil on the bottom. Now I'm going to take this towel and just take a part of it and just start rubbing it around, right? Now the towel did absorb a little bit of that. Man, I'm being noisy. So what I'm going to do is I'll put a little bit more oil in there. The towel did soak up some of that. And this, you know, the idea here is just to help with cleanup. You know, we just want to make things easy all the way around. We're in a weeknight here. We're going to cook a weeknight dinner. We want to be quick about getting it to the table. You know, the kids off doing homework right now and all that. So quick to the table, quick cleanup. Not any big deal for anybody. So first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my yellow onions that I have put into slices. I'm gonna lay those, some of those on the bottom. I'm gonna save others to go on the top. Now I've got my wedges of potato that I stored in the water to keep them from turning brown. So I'm gonna go drain these. I'll be right back. So the water helps prevent oxidation or the browning. It's technically called enzymatic browning. So since prep day, they've been stored in this water. All right, now. Now, you don't have to put your prep on these trays, but for me, I find that's really a lot easier if I can go in there and just look at, you know, pull a tray that has the dish on it. I've got it double checked on prep day, made sure I have everything there. So I'm just going to put these wedges in the bottom before we start layering our chicken in. And then some will go, we'll stick them around the sides. So this is, you know, we're basically, not basically, we are in fact cooking a whole chicken. I had a jumper. Make sure I don't step on that bad boy. There we go. Don't tell my wife I did that. Keep it between us, okay? All right, so I'm gonna get these taters down. And, then I'm actually going to grab the salt. Now the chicken was brined and I'll put a video up for my equilibrium brining video that is perfect for poultry and pork. So there will be a link for that. But I brined those prior to prep day. And then I broke them down into, I brined the whole chicken. Excuse me, I didn't brine the whole chicken. What it is, I brined the pieces, but I broke down the whole chicken. And so what we have is, we have a video on that breakdown. So I'll put a link to that as well. So you can see how to break down a bone-in. This is a bone-in 8-piece chicken. So now I just want to carefully pull it out of the marinade. And I'm going to just start finding spots for the chicken. So I separated that. If you watch that breakdown video, I separated these, the thighs away from the legs because my wife likes chicken legs and I like thighs. So this just makes it easy for us at dinner time to be able to separate those out. Pardon me. Man, the spices in here are getting to my nose. All right, see, how did that fit in there? About like that. And we got one more breast to put in. We've got a chicken wing here and another one right here. And I don't want to cover up the skin of the pieces because at the end, boy, I should have gotten a bigger pan. But we're actually going to put that under the broiler just to get a little color on it. And I don't think I'm going to be able to hold all of these potatoes, but I'm going to do my best. So I'm going to shove some potato wedges in here. So we can see that. And then I'll top it off with some onion slices. Oh man, this is going to be so stinking good. Oh, if you had smell-o-vision. Oh my goodness, it smells great. So here we go, just loading it up. I'm on a deadline, I better pick up the pace. But I want to get as much goodiness into this pan as I can. All right. So I think I've done it all. The rest will go to compost since I have cross-contaminated with the chicken juice here. But I'm going to take the rest of this marinade or the dressing, and all the measurements, by the way, is on the website, so check it out. But I'm going to pour it. Oh, wait, I forgot the rest of these onions. What is that? Oh, more onions. Okay, so I'm going to put some onions over. Yep. 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 Oh my goodness. Woo! Looking good. Looking good. See if I can shove some down in. These deli-tainers make prep day so easy. They just listen. That you got to get some. Just got to get some. All right. So now I'm going to pour the rest of this marinade over my onions and my potatoes. Oh my, it smells so good. But we're just doing a really quick weeknight dinner. It's obviously going to be a weeknight winner. All right, so now I've got some olives. I'll also need to put in a little pepper here. Yeah, looking good, looking good, looking good. So now I'm gonna take some olives and I'm just gonna sprinkle some around. Oh yeah. And then some lemon slices. like a bull in the stinking china closet. It's real life, man. I'm not cutting that out. You're going to see me do it. This is a live take. So I've got two less slices than I did, but that's all right. We're cooking with gas. You know what I mean? All right, so now we got that fixed. I'm going to put it in the oven. It's been preheated. I preheated it or started the oven when I walked in from work. Now I'm going to slide this in here uncovered, just like that. Slide that in, and then it's going to be in there about 45 minutes to an hour. Let me pick up this mess off the floor, put it in my compost bowl. All right. So now, clean up, move this off to the side. And what do we got next? Oh, let's do the tzatziki sauce. So what I've got here, so I've got a bowl. And you know, I could have done the tzatziki sauce, and maybe in hindsight, I would have or should have, so that it had more time for the flavors to marry, but I think we're going to be okay. So first thing I'm putting in is my couple cups of Greek yogurt. Use a Greek-style yogurt. Okay, got that in. Then I did the English cucumber, where I grated it, salted it, and then squeezed out the juice. Now I've got some fresh dill. I've also got some dill I'm going to use as a garnish, so let me set that out. Fresh dill. Then I've got some garlic. You can put as much or as little garlic as you want. If you're not a big garlic person, I mean, you don't even have to put it in, but Mediterranean food, Greek food, really does well when you have some garlic in there. So that looks like about 4 cloves. And again, I'm just guessing. I got a little pepper to put in here. Okay. And then a little bit of salt to bring all those flavors together. Oh, I forgot something. Let me get that out of the oven again. I cannot believe I forgot this. Throwing stuff on the floor, forgetting stuff. What happens now is I have a cup of chicken broth that I had made the other day. I'll put a link to that video there. Now I want to pour this, hope you can see me, but I'm pouring this from a corner so as not to take away any of the seasoning that's on top of the chicken or the potatoes. And I'm going to pour it in from one side. And I'm going to tilt the pan. Yeah, we got all that goodness down. Not that hot, but I'm not going to take a chance the way I've been doing it tonight. All right, so back in the oven you go. Oh, my goodness. Here we go. Now, I'm also going to put a little bit of olive oil. This is a Greek olive oil, about a tablespoon. Mix all this together. Mmm, I love a tzatziki sauce. Has a little bit of twang on it. Oh yeah, a little white wine vinegar goes in there. My mama used to say I'd lose my head if it wasn't attached to my shoulders. And so here I am. I got it laid out in front of me, forgetting stuff. But we're still going to get this done. All right, we got that mixed. So let me give this a quick taste test. Just a little bit more salt. Here we go. You know, it's really handy. Keep some tasting spoons on your kitchen counter by your stove. when you're seasoning, you can always determine what your seasoning is. Very handy, very helpful to do. And that, my friend, is it. Actually, say what it could use. A little bit of pepper. Maybe a pinch more salt. And just a little bit more garlic. My wife and I do like a lot of garlic. All right, so one final mix. I'm done here, promise. Not going to add anything else. So by doing your work on prep day, what you're doing is you're planning for your family and you're taking care of your time as well. That's an awesome thing to do because you can eat better at lower costs. When I say better, I mean not just flavor-wise, but also you pick the quality of the ingredients. And then you determine what goes in and what goes out. You can pronounce all the things you put in there. Now that's a tzatziki sauce. You can pronounce all those all the words, and you don't have to worry about something that was added that just isn't needed. So now, even though this tastes good now, I'm really kind of regretting not making this ahead of time. Because the flavors really would have come together. But this is delicious right now. And I needed something to do while the chicken was in the oven. But you're doing this on prep day. You're getting all your work done. Now, see, the whole thing is we love to cook, right? And so we don't want to give up cooking. We just want to do it smarter. So you have a day, one of your days off, an afternoon or whatever. And you do your prep work there. You get to enjoy the cooking. You get to play around, experiment. And what did I do with that? Somewhere or another. Oh, I set it over here. Yep. Lose my head if it wasn't attached to my shoulders. All right, so get that straightened up. Now, what I did was I took this dill, and you probably saw it on the prep day video. And I took and cut some of these dill fronds off for garnish on top, just to make it look pretty. And that's exactly what it's doing. Now, what I'm going to do with this is I'm going to take it and I'm going to put it right back in the fridge and let it hang out there. Okay? All right, that's done. Now, let's move on to the salad. So what do I have here for my salad? Greek salad. So in a Greek salad, we have no lettuce. So what we've got is that English cucumber. You know what? I need to put it in the bowl. That bowl. Then there's that English cucumber. I've got these black olives that are going in here. I've got these tomatoes. Now, you know, that you may not see a recipe that calls for the cherry tomatoes or the plum tomatoes, but I like those things in a salad. I think they're, you know, the bite size and all that good stuff. So I like it. Then some red onions, and I don't think I'm going to use all of these. One, my wife doesn't like onions, but I'm not going to waste these. These are actually going to be pickled. And then I've got these green bell pepper rings that I cut. And so then I've got half of this. This is dried oregano in here. Put half of it in. And we'll toss the veggies. Now here's the deal. I am not going to put my dressing on there until it's time to serve, because I don't want my veggies going soft and limp on me, right? So give that a toss. Then I'm going to put in the rest. The rest of the dried oregano. In there. Awesome. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to slip this off to the refrigerator to keep it cold. These spices, pardon me, you wouldn't need a sneeze. All right, we're going to keep that cold in there. Now I'm actually going to, by the way, I've got some feta cheese chunks that I'll put on after I dress it. So I'm going to go ahead and keep those in the refrigerator as well. Make sure that they don't get all soft on me. And now what I have is Greek olive oil. Have some red wine vinegar. Got some salt. And I'm going to throw in, just for grins and giggles, a little white pepper. Just for a little heat. And then I'm going to whisk it. Now, I'm whisking this. This will make a temporary emulsion. And I'll have to whisk it again. But I'll do that when it's time. So, there's our dressing. I'm going to put that in the refrigerator as well. And now, while you're waiting on the chicken, I'm going to hit the pause button. Want to stop the video right now. The timer's on pause. I'm not going to do anything with it other than pause it. And then when we come back, we'll finish up the chicken and we'll start the timer again and we'll finish it up. And then we'll see how well we did on the time. But you're putting together a gorgeous dinner in way under 30 minutes. So stop that timer and I will see you around the corner. All right, guys, we're done. Let's start the timer again. So let's pull this bad boy out. It's now, please be careful pulling this out of your oven, because all that marinade and the broth and all that is bubbling. It's very hot. The pan is hot. Got some nice color on here, so it is absolutely gorgeous. Let's go get the rest of dinner. All right, now let's grab the salad. Got the tzatziki sauce. By the way, don't want to forget, tzatziki sauce goes here. I'm going to go get my pita bread. But I'm going to do that after I toss my salad, okay? So let me get everything together. By the way, I did turn off the oven for the pita bread, and so that's really really just sitting in a very warm oven right now. So I'm going to go ahead now. Silly me, I shoved my whisk into a dishwasher, and I got the timer running, so I'm not going to go get it. So now just going to have to make do. Also, my tongs, I don't have those either. So I'm going to drizzle this just dump it all in. There we go. You know what I am going to do? I'm going to grab a glove, and that way I can use my hand as a tong. Oh my goodness, it smells so good. All right, so my Greek salad is now tossed. One last thing. Get this pita bread out of the oven. You know, we did all the heavy lifting on prep day. Be sure to check out that video. Um, but this is amazing. So let's get some of this toasted pita bread. This is absolutely fantastic. Wow. Like a nice little thing going around. Also, I'm going to post a video on how to make this pita bread on my baking channel. I'll let you know when that comes out. And you know what? Let me get that out of the way. I just can't, I can't help myself. So here we go. Oh my. So what do we have? Gosh, not, I almost double dipped. What do we have? Well, we have this beautiful roast Greek chicken and potatoes. We did in the oven. We did everything on prep day. We did marinate the chicken as we left for work this morning. And so when we got in, all we had to do is preheat the ovens, change clothes, assemble the casserole, put it in the oven. While it was in the oven, we made the tzatziki sauce, and we got our veggies tossed and ready to go for the dressing. And I'm going to say stop the timer because we're done. This is dinner. Oh, one last thing. No, don't stop the timer. Sprinkle some feta on top of that. You can go heavy. You can go light. It looks like a pretty good amount right there. Now stop the timer. Here we go. Kids, super easy, super quick. We use prep day to get us ready to do this. And then we just come in and throw it together, pop it in the oven. We go off, help the kids with their homework, watch a quick little television show. You know, maybe even watch a cooking show on YouTube. How that for an idea? So this is it. By the way, thank you for joining me on the Chef Lance Show. And always remember this. A day in the kitchen beats a day of working any day. We'll see you next time.